is a thing to be happy, Dom.
It is.
You are.
I am. There's no secret to it, Ben. There's only this. Do not care for all but what you may throw your arms about. Decide who that may be. Forget what remains beyond.
That is no counsel for a copper.
I never said it was. It is counsel for a man, however, who would know what life is, not the other.
Man in uniform beneath us. Do you blush on my account, John?
It is coarse. And you're about as far from coarse as a man might imagine, Tilda.
You know, John, you must not make a princess out of me.
But that is the way I feel about you, however, Tilda. A princess to me.
Then you must stop. There is something I've learned, and learned to my cost, Samuel Drummond. It is that life is not a fairy tale, and that those who seek to make it one too often do so the real and felt unhappiness of their actual lives. Do you understand?
I am not unhappy, Matilda.
I could make you so, however. I could make you so and fast. There are no princesses and no monsters. Only humans. Their flesh and bones and all too broken hearts. I am fond of you because you are real. And I cannot find anything hidden or broken about you. You must be fond of me because I too am real. Do you see?
I do.
Whitechapel Beast slays again. Jewish immigrant murdered. Excuse me, sir.
Sit! Come in, have the drink.
I should have known.
Edmund Reid betrays his
badges, uniform, his brother men.
No, I told you, Inspector Drake, and you would not hear it from me. I will not stand idle whilst Whitechapel falls beneath terror, a terror in which I believe Assistant Commissioner Dove to be implicated.
Now, this will break him from his cover.
And break our good name alongside.
Our good name be damned. Miss Costello, will you show him?
Here, you may recognize Leon Ratovsky. This image recorded the day he led his people out of the Russian Empire.
What are these? Towns, villages?
They are shtetl.
They are the towns and villages where the Jewish people of Russia were tolerated to live for a while.
Until living there became intolerable.
These then their journeys as they fled, those that made their eventual way to London.
Go on.
I first heard the name Ratovsky 2 years ago from one who followed him, a woman. The only surviving member of her family to have reached London. And though her grief was still great, so was her gratitude. To the man, the rabbi who had led their caravan west. I recorded the name, Leon Ratovsky, and then put that record aside.
Until the time you heard his name again?
The victim of a murder. About which you, Mr. Drake, would reveal barely more than a sentence of information until the murderer was named Isaac Bloom. Another Jewish man to have made such a journey. Yet still, although I make daily requests for details, none are forthcoming from you, sir. Or your superior at Scotland Yard, Assistant Commissioner Dove, who proceeds to injunct all details of your case. I am afraid I am perverse. Being barred from asking questions has a tendency to make me ask more. This week last, I traveled to Paris, where his friends at the Sorbonne allowed me to remove these photographs. And these.
They are his diaries.
And you've read these?
They are in Ukrainian. He cannot.
Well, then, they must be translated.
They are being so.
Rabaratovsky's own account of a journey at the head of 150 men, women, and children, a community of Jews, then supplemented by a further diaspora, Christians fleeing north from the Balkan Peninsula.
In the Russian Empire, the Tsars drove out the Jews. In the Ottoman, the Sultan drove out the Christians. Peoples leaving all they have known behind, massing, driving west for salvation.
It is a hard road, however, and this Rabaratovsky is the hardest.
In daylight, breaking camp, I see them. Perhaps 50 yards from us, watching through the trees. A wolf pack. I say nothing to the group we walk on. The whole day they follow, they are to the south of us, perhaps an hour later to the north. We camp at nightfall. I instruct fires to be built on our perimeter, and I am asked why. I do not need to find an answer, because that is when they begin to howl. The first night they take two, an elderly couple. We know nothing of this until their screams erupt from the darkness beyond our fires. They scream for what feels like many hours. By morning, there is nothing left of them except blood in the snow. The following night, they come again, but now they take five. Two young girls among them. Again, we must listen to their screams. And so it proceeds, day by day, as we walk through the forest. We see them close. Their pups gambling alongside. And each night, they attack, and we listen to our wives, our husbands, our parents, our children screaming, and imagine that one night soon, it will be ourselves going beneath their jaws. 2 weeks, we walk through the forest like this. And on the last night, however, the wolves take a woman, a Christian woman, Goluba. I remember her name because she was the last, and also because her two sons attempted to fight the animals. Perhaps for this reason, the wolves did not remove her corpse, instead left her there in the snow, her insides all about her, and the youngest of her sons still clutching at her cold body. Rutovsky told Isaac Bloom that he had come to London to right a wrong, and he would only say that this wrong constituted an abandonment.
The later entries, his arrival in Paris, he talks of being broken, unable to continue, unable to lead his people further.
So the caravan breaks up, men, women, and children going where they may, and some we know, correct, Miss Castella, to London. So perhaps these two brothers were forced to go on without Rutovsky, and is this that abandonment?
Two small boys, alone and orphaned, their memories, who they felt themselves to be, shaped and fathered by the beast they met in that forest.
Now grown to adulthood. Homo homini lupus est.
Man is wolf to man. Before Rutovsky was found, weeks before, do you recall, Deborah? The talk had started. A figure seen on rooftops, watching those of this community. What they called the Whitechapel Golem.
So what has become a rabid violence begins with a surveillance.
Like the wolves stalking the caravan.
Two boys, two Christian boys, the sons of the wolves' last victim, are given shelter by a Jewish community. Whilst in their care, they are exposed to this bestial horror. Now, in adulthood, one of them seeks to visit the same horror within the same community.
So is Rutovsky brought here to tend, to counsel, only to fall beneath the jaws of the wolf?
Invited by one brother to attempt the healing of the other.
The woman's name. Do you recall that? Birdseller. I had a stall off the back of Fashion Street. I once bought Rose Lovebirds from
him. I remember him.
He was a gypsy. Made great play of it. His Balkan Romany roots. Goluba was the word he used for a dove. He makes his mother's name English. Redefines himself with it. Miss Costello, you will now set your curiosity to Assistant Police Commissioner Augustus Dove. Find him, follow him, report to me. It will be more than a book you will write. More than our good name will be bankrupted. You will show the world a darkness sat at the heart of Scotland Yard itself.
We all knew it, when we were all scratched together. We all knew you would become the model of what a man might be. even when you were a boy. Augustus Starr. We girls would fight and scratch for who one day might be your woman. How is it you're alone, Augustus?
I do not know, Rose. All I know is it saddens me. It saddens me something fearful.
Do not be sad, Augustus. Do not be. There is too much confusion in the world for a young, handsome man to be sad. Not too far, Connor.
Rose, may I ask you something?
Of course you may.
Your words to me. Your recent words of Miss Hart and how she and Mr. Reid had collaborated on some act of evil.
You said I should keep my secrets.
I did. I know.
Well, who could blame him for it, Billy? His daughter. It was his child. But Susan, what she did...
Rose, forgive me. I do not follow.
It was her father. Eador Swift. Her own flesh and blood. And God help him, Bennett. Stood by and watched as they put him in that cellar. The same cellar that re-popped that child stealer's head open on a stone pillar. Oh, but I am faithless.
You are not, Rose. You are nothing of the kind. You hold to what is right and true, not to lies and secrecy. And murder, Rose. What they did was murder.
Two men for three vases. Does that represent a good deal?
Oi, I tell you again, their blood is on my hands. Now, we may waste no time.
Yes, I understand that, Croker.
Then take one vase, only one, mind, to that fence off Ratcliffe Highway and get your prize.
I have little choice, do I?
You've arranged our berths, then.
Boston, the best I can do in such short order.
Boston will serve fine.
And you bring me my money, hook your child, and I shall... Where do you see?
Just a word, Croker, before I leave.
No.
That's your boy, isn't it?
He is. Not my blood, but he is my boy.
You know what your boy's been about late? Now, most other weeks, I just shoot him here and now. But this ain't other weeks, so I only ask you this. If I leave my wife with you for another 2 hours, is she safe?
Well, what is it you accuse him of, Captain? I cannot vouch for her safety if I do not know this.
Now, you know goddamn well what the threat is. And what he's done, I can only leave that on your conscience, Abel. But you vouch for her safety. And you do it now.
She will be safe.
On your life, Croker.
On my life.
She ain't. He even gives her a stir. I will hunt him and kill him, but not before I've shot you first. You hear me?
I hear you.
What gives, Abel?
Take this to the station house on Leaving Street.
Sir.
What is it, Sergeant?
Our dead room reaches capacity. The cage on the customs warehouse on Cutler Street was blown open last night. Two guards killed.
What thieved?
Three porcelain vases.
It's your case, Sergeant. You see it through.
Sirs, I think you must see this.
Captain Jackson?
Not in his rooms, Inspector.
Usual gin and flop houses.
Men search for some without him. We keep looking, however.
So it was you who was stripped then?
No, sir. That was myself. Sergeant Thatcher found the action, not to his taste.
It was the wounding. Blood spilling from the same piece of him.
Upper left thorax.
See, I think the instinct accurate.
It's the same wounding. One you must kill for necessity.
These. Mr. Nagelman, Mr. Rutovsky before him, this. This is the animal unleashed.
Mr. Reid, sir? Which animal?
This is fine work. But I think you both must leave us now.
What? No. Inspector.
Get out, Thatcher.
Thank you.
We believe Augustus Stav about the thieving of Japanese porcelain also.
And more besides.
The world beside.
Who here carries the biggest truncheon?
What is it he wants, small fry?
You, is it?
Come on.
Oi! I only came to run you a note.
Then give it.
Tip off. Cut the street job. Knows where the items to be fenced. Drum, what'd you do?
Inspectors.
Inspectors be bollocks. This is our bloody collar.
Parker?
No. I'm Thatcher.
Thatcher.
Bloody thieving, conniving, backstabbing. Americans.
God damn it. You really gonna make me do this, huh? There's some morphine about the place. You do me a favor and fix him up with some brandy, because my head is broke. Oh.
Everything you know, now.
I know you punch like a choir boy.
There's a rope with your name on it. Soon.
Look, Jake, I'd really like to help nearly all women, but I don't know nothing. So why don't you be a good little nurse and go and get me my morphine?
Wait a minute.
Oh, what's wrong? Your two stars still crossed, boys? You're out of conditioning, Reed.
I'm not no surgeon, nor no Pinkerton, but I'm no fool neither. These knife wounds are the same, and as you, with such precision, pointed out, he who killed Thomas Gower killed this poor immigrant nobleman, killed Leon Rutowski also. And now, I believe, has put his knife between these two men's ribs during a robbery which you, in one way or another, have partaken. Any way you choose to slice it, Captain, you are up to your guts in this. So you tell me who done it!
Just pass me a smoke, will you? Were you part of this robbery last night? If you were not, how did you get your hands on this vase? Well, that's a good many questions, Reed. Which one's your favorite? Despite your self-interest, I know that you are not the stripe of man to let others suffer while you might instead help. Now, we know not how, but Augustus Stav himself is somehow also tangled within all. So I ask you again. Only help. I only wish I could, Reid. You know, I'm
glad of something. The man you were when we first met, a man of war, a man of dread, his least fighting dog. And now all that you have constructed about yourself now, Dre, it's a man of peace, a man of hope. It's a relief for me to see it. Just how brittle a carapace that was. How little a man can change.
Inspectors. Sir, she has brought herself here. Miss Costello, sir, she asks after you.
Have two men lock this horse and down.
Rare blend our surgeon has taken to smoking. One cannot imagine its importance being that many and varied. So get on the line to the shipping office at the Western for a note who lumps such tobacco ashore for.
You're sure?
I'm afraid so.
Leave us now. They are friends, are they not? From childhood, school together.
Such friends do not walk arm in arm. Do not care for all but what you may throw your arms about.
It will not serve anyone, least of all yourself, to reach a conclusion that you have not seen firsthand, which you cannot prove. I see your rage. I do, but do not feed it. Leave me for now to join this robbery with Mr. Duff, and you go home. Bennett, go home with love in your heart. Yes, Drummond.
Three different merchants, three different war sites. Only, here's the point of interest, Mr. Reid. Shipping office reports an identical inquiry taking place a couple of weeks back. A fella named Probin, prison doctor.
Egyptian. Nutty. Cut with sweetness. They're strong. And rare. Only a very few importers. To a clear trail to its source. A trail stepped by another in recent times. That doctor out of Newgate. Remember his name? It was Probin. He ministered to your wife, I believe. Before she died, or did not die, if Rose Drake is to be believed. I only mention this out of fellowship due to the fact that time presses, and I believe you may be able to save me a diversion or two. Which of the three wharves that land this tobacco should I go to first? And what will I find there?
Reid, I think you know what it is. You ask me that, it ain't just a name I'm gonna give you.
I do.
Then in fellowship, don't ask it.
I must.
And yet, I have no notion of what it is you speak, Reid. Reid, you be careful down there.
What dangers do I face?
Plenty.
This your sarcophagus, is it, madam? Where you have come to in your death.
And who else to break me from my tomb but you? Mr. Reid.
It is fortunate that I am in the habit of believing the evidence of my eyes. I might, like Rose Drake, consider my wits lost to me, having watched you fall from the scaffold. At some point in time, I shall be very interested to know how you did it. Although, I have some idea, given that your husband is currently in irons at Dean Street. Tip-off, apparently. Apprehended in the process of selling stolen goods, the anticipated profit from which to provide the wherewithal for your further flight, I imagine. An escape of ruthlessness and ingenuity, one that might have been worthy of you, madam.
Escape? It is a fine fancy. But no more than that. And you, Mr. Reid, a man equally resurrected, equally powerless to leave a place, come to show me my truth once more. Yourself, myself. Attached to Whitechapel as if by lead weights on a riverbed. The betrayal of my husband. It is the same communication that has brought you here now.
No. Merely police work. And who your betrayer? The Warfinger here, Croker.
So it would seem. My son. Will I see my son?
Not of current relevance. I'm sure some visitation might be arranged before... Well, before the law of this land makes one further attempt to see you punished.
I would have accepted it, my hanging. You must understand that, Mr. Reid. I would have given my life in recompense for all I have taken and done it with peace. But they let me raise my boy. And once I had known him, I could not relinquish that.
That's this most recent thieving of yours. Dead men at your door, yet again, in your pursuit of freedom.
I know it. Mourn them. Now also their mourning barely worth the saying of.
No. And who was it? Who was it but the knife? It is you.
No, no. You take his man's life, Nathaniel. You must take mine first. You know what it's like to protect, and I must protect him. I must.
Nathaniel, is it? What was it before? What was it when the wolves came for you? Who is he?
He's Reid. He's my friend.
He's police, is he not?
He is.
You are the younger. You who lay beside your mother in the snow. And who is the older, Nathaniel? You tell me. I believe I know, but you tell me. You confirm it. Did you run to him? Did you confess what you've done to Ratovsky?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Susan. I'm sorry.
Wait! Wait!
Mr. Drake, I thought to deliver your wife home.
What is it you thought to deliver her from, Mr. Duff?
Philip, you know full well we are friends. Oh, should I not accept a carriage ride home when all about is uproar?
It is as Rose says, Inspector.
Mrs. Drake. She's Mrs. Drake to you.
As Mrs. Drake has said, these are dangerous days, and if it is in my gift to afford you a measure of peace by returning...
Philip! Oh. Augustus!
Oh. Oh. Get him away. Get the boy out, Rose.
Want me to take his eyes away? Spare your shame for you, I will not.
On your head be it then, woman. Your own selfish needs, and I a slave to each and every one of them. And now this!
Ed.
What are you?
Roots!
Did you let him touch you? Have you taken him to our bed?
No, Benny!
Perhaps she speaks the truth. What of your truth, eh?
Anything.
You have camouflaged yourself to me with great skill, sir. But there is a ripe stink about you now. We have it in the air, and we are coming for you, Mr. Duff.
I will build high walls to make you and your child safe. Only you must choose a side now, my Rose. The cellar. Where may I find it?
You know I'm ready, Augustus. It was beneath that curiosity shop.
Susan Hart.
True name!
Swift. Caitlin Swift.
Inspector Drake! Sir. Please, sir. There is a unit at Westminster Manor. Yard, uniforms, A Division, sir. Over 50 of them. They've sealed up the Cobden estate on Saunders Street. And they're clearing out the tenants. Arrest warrant. Inspectors Reid and Drake to be apprehended and held on the order of Assistant Commissioner Duff.
First of those men out there to feel that their prospects might be advanced by our shackling.
We will not. Perhaps I am only good for the fight after all.
Then let us bring it, Bennett!
The brother's Duff.
Susan Hart. That woman there.
The woman Swift, she saved me from that creature. He would have had that knife up under my ribs in a trice, but he obeyed her command. She and her husband also, they know this Nathaniel. When we find him, his capture will bring us also to his brother.
With me.
Stand down, Connor. Just go. Get out. Move! Get walking.
Jackson's a fix.
Do it, Drummond!
Inspector, will you not even make it appear as if we tried to do our duty?
Rose, do you have my son? I don't know how you dare ask. He is at home, being watched by real policemen.
Rose, please. None of this is as I would have wanted it. You are so dear to me. But my deception, can you? Will you understand how?
I think you've said your piece now, Mrs. Drake.
I ain't even begun, Captain. Do you know what he and I have suffered, and all for the true love of you? And we have done it together, but that love is now broke and forgot. So you may run, but do not think you will ever see your son again. You gave him to me. You died, and you remain dead. And if I see you again, no, Susan, I will kill you myself.
We must run. We must run.
Is it you, Rose? You who sent Mr. Duff to that cellar? What happened to us? Drake, now!
You are a fine sight, Matilda Reid.
Your eyes did not deceive you, Matilda. It is her. And thanks, Miss Costello. We must speak. There will be bad things said about me. Things that perhaps you will not recognize as acts I could have carried out.
Then are they true?
Some, yes. Matilda Reid. The girl born to me twice. No wonder of the woman you have become.
No. Not again, Father. Do not leave me.
You stay close to your Samuel Drummond. Understand? He loves you. We'll keep you safe.
Matilda, this is the most important. You must deny me. You must openly state that any love for your father has been extinguished by what you have learned of him. Should you need to speak with me, place a candle in your window. Miss Costello, you will be watched. So you play the innocent for now. Elsie will see you dead. Understand? Now we go hunting.
Search the link. Watch out, plus it's a commercial problem.
Let him through. Yes, Sergeant Drummond.
Mr. Dove, sir, there is a delivery for you. A boy brought this, sir.
Reed put him up and sent him running. But there is no rat hole in Whitechapel where he can hide from me.
Feel this need for me.
I do, and more besides. It was you instructed me to keep wearies on him, but I cannot make that my life's sole calling if the watching of him must be done each and every minute of each and every day. He can't help himself, and I do not know of any other way of doing it.
He is chained, Abel. My brother is chained.
As all animals require, chaining or slaying.
What's that you say?
Only this, that I should have tied him up in a sack and put him in the river when I first saw him. He is past saving. Augustus, and you and your ever-burgeoning eminence needs protection from him.
So you think to end his misery?
I do.
And wish for my sanction?
I do not require your sanction. A pair of you would have been ground down for bread had it not been for me. I do you the respect of telling you is all.
Augustus, what's he saying? I will be better. Or will be calm, I promise.
Go then. But make it swift.
Lord, Lord, Lord. There will be a peace, my boy.
My blood, eh? What else would I do?
Cloak to reveal the truth of himself.
I think it is unlikely they will return now. Unless it is Augustus Dove and 20 men hoping to make our capture. Until we are apprehended, I do not think your croaker will return that creature here.
They're ours, goddammit. Stolen in good faith and worth a bundle. A bundle we four could well benefit from.
We four? I'm not your brother in outlaw arms.
Oh, are you not? Why don't you go trot back to your desk then?
I believe I have some instinct as to where your quarry may now hide itself.
Where'd he say?
Somewhere. It is a whole system of tunnels.
What do you want, brother?
What do you want?
To live. Grow old. Be happy.
It's the same as me, Augustus. But I cannot, because what I want is not what I need.
Need never dies, does it, boy? Storm blows up for a score of wherefores, but the sailing remains the same. Augustus, he ain't your mainsail. He ain't even your anchor. He is the teeth of the hurricane. He's your kraken waking.
Perhaps, but he is mine. Listen, you
Do not look for me, understand? Go, brother. Hide. I shall find you.
Yes, Gustus.
I gave you life.
It is not a gift, Abel.
Where is your creature?
Please, Abel, only tell us.
It's like parallel paths. Our eyes on each other's torch.
Show yourself to me. It will only be a looking in the mirror after all. Believe yourself a cruel man, do you? Believe this life only hung for that cruelty to breed? You do not know the bastard of it. How many then? Huh? Rutovsky? My boy Gower? The immigrant, Nagelman? Them two guards? Let us hazard perhaps two or three more along the way. Six, say. Six is nothing, boy! I ended 20 men beneath these hands in only one half a hot morning.
With me!
fight.
Look, my friend. I'm a fight. There.